Hi there, you're watching IT Taster, and in this video I'm going to show you how to configure a template user account in Windows Server 2019. Now this is something that will also work with earlier versions of Windows Server, and it's a really useful admin tip because it enables us to build a template user account so that when a new user joins an organization, we can import some of the settings that we've configured and build our new user from there. Now, before we get started, don't forget to subscribe to the IT Taster channel if you haven't already. Give the video a like or drop a comment below. And I'm also around on social media, and I'll leave the links to that in the description below this video. So with that said, let's go over to the lab and the server and let's get started. So let's begin by logging into the server. Now, when we log in, Server Manager will of course start by default, but if it doesn't, you can access it from the Programs menu in the usual way. So I'm going to go to Tools, and I'm going to choose Active Directory Users and Computers. And this is where we do most of the administration from. And I'm going to expand my domain, which is training.ittaster.com. Now, you can see here that I have a few organizational units created already. We have marketing users, sales users, and technical users. Now, if you're not familiar with organizational units, they basically allow us to group some of our Active Directory objects. Things like computers and users are a good example. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to create a template user, and I'm going to do that within the technical users organizational unit. So I right click the organizational unit, and I'm going to choose new and choose user. And for the user's name, I'm going to begin with an underscore because a non-alphanumeric character will cause this account to appear at the very top of the list and make it easy to find. So I'm going to call it technical user template. And that's the same login name I'm going to use as well. I'm just going to call it technical user template and click next. There's a couple of things I'm going to do here. I'm going to take out the user must change password at next login. I'm going to set the account to disabled, and I'm going to set user cannot change password. And I'm also going to specify a password as well. Now the reason I've chosen to disable the account, because this is a template user, we don't want this account being active, so it's good for security to make sure it's disabled. And also when we come to create a user from it later on, we have the choice of enabling our users when they're ready. So I'm going to click next and finish, and we now have our user template account here. I'm just going to go back into it and fill out a couple of things. For example, I can fill in the office, which is the technical department. And if I go across to the account, I can do things like change login hours if I want to. You know, we can set which hours the user is able to log on here if we want to. I'm not going to do that at this stage. The next thing I'm going to do is go to profile, and here we can specify things like a login script. So I can specify the login script of technical.bat for the technical department. And I can also do things like specify a home folder as well. So I'm going to choose drive H for my home folder. But don't worry about this at the moment. The main idea, the main thing to come away with, is that we can configure a lot of our user settings in advance. So if you are interested in things like home folders, we can look at that in another video. So I'm going to specify the path to where the home folders live, which is server one, home. I call it home underscore folders. Dollar, and I'm going to use the wildcard percent username percent. Now this is a wildcard, and it's a way of represent, it's like a variable, it's like a way of representing any user. So I'm going to click apply, And as you can see, it's completed that path, and it's changed the percent username percent to the actual username, which is our technical user template. I don't think there's too much else I'm going to do here. I think I'm happy with everything. You can fill in things like phone information, but again, because it's a generic account, it may be specific to a particular user, so I'm not going to do too much here. Under organization, again, we might put something in like the technical department. We can do that. And we can also put the company name in if we wanted to as well. Now, the last thing I'm going to do is go to member of. And this is where we specify things like group memberships. Now, this can be really, really useful because when we have a new employee starting, we want to make sure that they are members of the correct groups, because this will give them access to appropriate resources in terms of files and printers and things like that. So I'm going to click add. And there are a few groups here that I'm going to choose. I have an all staff group. So I'm just type all, check names. We've got all staff there. So I'm going to add that. I'm going to add help desk. Okay, so this user is now a member of the groups that I want them to belong to and be able to access resources. So that's pretty much all done, so we can click OK. Now the next thing we want to do is actually create a user from this user template. And this is really easy to do. Simply right-click the user template, choose copy, and then we need to complete the user details. So for example, here we're going to go with Bill Gates, and we'll specify the login name, which is going to be GatesB. Click Next. Now you'll notice we're seeing here the account is disabled and the user cannot change passwords that we specified within the user template. So I'm going to take out user cannot change password. I'm going to set that to user must change password at next login. Specify a password. I'm going to leave the account disabled at this stage. In the real world, it might be we might be waiting for the HR department to give us the go ahead that, you know, all checks have completed and the user is ready to start. So I'm going to leave that disabled at this stage and click Next. And then click Finish. And you'll see there's our new user. Now, if I double click on our new user, Bill, and we'll just look at some of the configuration settings. If we go to Profile, we can see that our login script is already there. Our home folder is already specified. Now, notice the path. Server 1, Home Folders, Gates B. Now remember, because we use that wildcard, that percent username percent, it's automatically changed the username to GatesB and created a home folder for that user, which is really, really useful. And the other important thing to note, of course, is if we go to member of, you can see here that Bill is a member of our all staff group and our help desk group as well. So as you can see, it's really easy to create a template user account, populate it with configuration settings, and then go on to create a new user account from that. Now you can, of course, have multiple user template accounts that you can call on for different roles within an organization. And it's something that can make a server admin's life a great deal easier. Well, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you found it helpful. Please give the video a like if you did, and drop a comment below if you have any feedback. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the IT Taster channel if you haven't already. And why not drop by on social media? I'll leave the links below in the video and say hi there too. So, as always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.